Hey guys, EBP Man here, and today I'm going to give you four power tips that are going to transform the way you send text messages. Let's get right to it. Now in today's video, I'm going to share with you four power tips that are really going to transform how you use text messaging in your Samsung Galaxy S10, S10 Plus, or S10e. Matter of fact, this is gonna go back and work on the S9 and the S8 as well. So let me show you everything I do when I use text messages and how I get the most out of my phone. Let's get right to it.
Make sure you hit the subscribe button and tap the little bell icon to get notified when new videos become available.
So now this first tip is gonna be great, especially if you travel or you wanna send someone a message, but you don't wanna send it right now at that moment. Let me show you how this works. And type in the word test, which is gonna be my text message. But you notice that there's a plus sign in the side. Now, instead of just hitting send, I'm gonna hit plus. And as I hit plus, you'll notice there's something there that says schedule message. When I choose schedule message, what will now happen is it's gonna give me the opportunity to set the date and time for this message to go out. So let's say you're typing up a message that you wanna send somebody at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, the same day or the next day. I can choose the date that I want the message to go out, the time that I want it to go out. So I'm gonna say 3 in the afternoon. And then when I hit done, and I hit done one more time, that message, when I hit send, is not gonna go out. You'll notice that it has a little clock on there and it says test, because that message is gonna go out at that time on that day. This is a great feature, especially if you travel and you're in different time zones, or just think about it. You basically need to send someone a message. You wanna send a reminder, like pick up the milk, or stop at the store, or pick something up, but you don't wanna do it at that specific moment. You could set it at a specific time and a specific date when it's most important. All right, so this next tip has to do with reminders, how you can take a text message and turn it to something that's gonna remind you. So let me show you how this works. I'm gonna press and hold on this one. It says, call me when you leave, press and hold, and I'm gonna say send to reminder. And now there's a little clock here that I'm tapping on, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna choose the date and the time that I want it to remind me. So let's say I'm in at work right now and I leave at 5 o'clock. So I'll pretend that today is Monday and I'm gonna set this to 5 p.m. and I'm gonna tell it I want it to remind me at that time. So a reminder will appear at 5 p.m. That way you never forget when you get a text message. All right, so this next feature has to do with reminders, but still now using your location to kick off the reminder. Let me show you this one right here. So I have that I need to be able to stop at the store to pick up some milk. So I'm gonna press and hold the button right here. I'm gonna say send to reminder. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna choose the clock again, but this time I'm gonna pick a place. So this is a great feature because what you could do is actually set a specific street or address so that when you approach it, the reminder will kick off. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna press and hold at a specific location, and that is as soon as I drive, this is the path that I drive every day to and from work. As soon as I hit that specific location, it says when I arrive at that location, my reminder is gonna trigger. I could also say when I leave that location. So I could set it to my work address where I'm at, and when I leave, it could go off. So I'm gonna say when I arrive at, and I'm gonna hit done. And what will happen is it will log it will reference the street or the intersection that I was at where I tapped, and as soon as I get to that point, you're gonna get that reminder. So if you have a message that you want to recall really quickly, you want to kind of bookmark it, let me show you how that's done. You're going to press and hold on the message that you want, and you'll notice that there's a feature there that says star the message. Starring the message is going to allow you to find this message a lot faster. It's like putting a little flag on a little post-it note. Now, let me show you one more thing before I show you how you find that. If you press and hold on it, you can unstar that message as well. So you can turn it on or you can turn it off. Now, when you're looking in your main message area, what you could do is you can choose star messages, and then when you choose your star message area, all the messages that have a star will show up. So this is a quick way to find your messages without having to hunt through all your messages. Now, this next tip is a bonus tip. Let's say you don't have the time to type a message back, but you can't speak it. On the right side, you see this little squiggly line. If you press and hold, you can actually send your message to the person by using your voice, and that's what's happening right now. All right, guys, so those were my four tips for text messaging and one power tip at the very end using the voice recorder. Let me know if you have any tips or tricks that you use when using text messaging. And if any of these were new to you, I'd love to hear from you in the comment area below. Thanks for watching.